Hello everyone! While I was doing my last pixel art illustration, this one with the ZX Spectrum palette you see here, I used the technique called HD index painting for the first time. Now, HD index painting is a technique I learned from Dan Fessler, and it allows you to paint dithering with your stylus. As you can see in the background, it allows me to just use brush strokes with opacity and pressure sensitivity to approach pixel art as if it was a painting. There are three ways I do dithering in this piece. The first one is the obvious one that we all know, is the manual, where you just place pixels down by hand. The second one, which I talked in my previous dithering tutorial, is the use of layer masks, where you first lay down the base colors and then use a layer that has a halftone mask applied to it to then just paint over with the stylus in broad brush strokes the dithered colors. And then HD index painting allows me to just use normal soft brushes in Photoshop and pressure sensitivity to paint with Photoshop automatically generating dithering patterns for me. And it's even a bit more crazy than that, because then you can play with the layers to adjust dithering on the fly and even how many shades in the palette you wanna generate. I drew most of this image in GIMP, where I used the layered mask approach to dithering, which you can see here. If I turn it on and off, you can see which parts are coming from the dither layer. And then for the background, you see those blue parts? I moved to Photoshop and decided I'm gonna give HD index painting a try. It seemed like a perfect example where I could use it. To set up HD index painting, you first have a normal paint layer where you're going to use soft brushes to paint with black and white, so in shades of gray, using your stylus. Then the next thing we do is create an adjustment layer called posterize, which changes the amount of shades down to only a few levels, which you can set here with the level slider. And now the important part for dithering to happen is to also create a new layer that is filled with a dither pattern, and you can get these dither patterns from Dan Fessler's website, link in the description. And what happens is, when you turn the opacity down, it will eventually start looking pretty neat. So usually when you are painting, you already have all these layers set up, so you just paint and see the immediate results happening. And at first you might think that this does not give you enough control, but there's nothing stopping you from actually going in, zooming in, and just getting to the details with a pixel brush and get those details just right with the precision that you expect from pixel art. So here is how the results look like in practice on my illustration. If I take all the layers away, here you can see this is the base painting layer, and then I apply the posterize adjustment layer with only two levels, because I only need two shades. And so I was very, very happy with the results I was getting. The precision is quite all right, and I found that I can move from drawing to erasing quite efficiently to manipulate the shapes that I was trying to get. Since you're still watching, let's also nerd a little bit about how this technique works. What the posterize filter does is, it goes from, usually we have 256 shades per red, green, and blue channel, and the posterize layer just puts this down to as many levels as we want. For example, just two, it's just gonna turn all the shades of gray into just either black or white. So if you imagine this as a function, then there's this division line that's going to push all of the colors below it to zero and all of the ones above it to 255. Now when we fill in the dither pattern, we basically have this channel of different shades of grays interchanging in this step-like level, but then when we lower the opacity down, we're kind of compressing all of this into just this small little range. And now when we combine this dither pattern at low opacity with the original gradient, we basically get this upwards incline, but with these little ridges in it. And so what happens is, when we posterize, again, things below the blue dividing line will go to zero and things above will go to white. But in this middle area, there's going to be a range where it's, because of this application of the pattern, it's going to just bounce wildly up and down, which actually just creates the dither pattern. So that's why using different dither patterns will create different results, and also applying them with different modes, for example, with normal or overlay, will also slightly change the results because it changes how the two underlying functions are combined. I hope you have found this information useful. There are more nuances to this and I will talk more about them in the future. There's also my quick dithering tutorial about the layer technique that also touches about this. You should watch, and don't forget you can support me on Patreon for more pixel art tutorials in the future. Thank you so much.